The Vitality Seminar was incredibly helpful to starting us down the path of looking at serving outside of our building differently. Without the Vitality Seminar, our leaders, our congregation would not have contemplated doing anything differently from a ministry perspective in terms of serving others.
So I attended the Vitality Seminar. I was just a member of the church and a small group leader at the time, so I attended. It was a overwhelming, inspiring, and kind of a how are we going to do this type of seminar. Coming from a different kind of background growing up in different churches, it was pretty foreign to me to even the concept of getting outside of the walls and having programs that didn't live within the church and wasn't focused on Bible studies or even small groups, but getting out in your community and serving and building relationships.
I had the opportunity to sit during the Vitality Seminar for a brief period at the end of it. It became very evident that I needed to play a role in this. In some way, I felt called by God to be a part of this. And the reason being is because for the previous 21 years, prior to this meeting, I've been a police officer in the inner city of Columbus, Ohio. And I have seen churches come and go through those time and days there where I've seen things that, hey man, you could have a heck of an impact on a community that is in need of what's missing. And that thing that has been missing is the relationship with Christ. And they were doing impactful things, but they were doing it for a short period of time. So this seminar actually allowed us to, again, focus on where it is that we want to go, where are we feeling called, and through the vision team, that process was made it very clear, and we ended up in the community to which I had been a police officer for 21 years, which was the Linden community in Columbus, Ohio. We were able to reach out to several of the local schools. One was a pre-K school. That also led to the Linden McKinley High School, which is in the same community, which led to a gentleman who was doing Fellowship of Christian Athletes at that high school, which plugged us into now the high school kids, which led us to a family to which, through my job, I was able to create a relationship with. And the kids from that family actually go to another local elementary school, which, again, we have been able to start a relationship or a partnership with them. Not by coincidence that all these things happen. It was obviously God was clearly calling us to go and serve because of those opportunities, because of those moments and times that we've been able to sit together and beside one another and hug and cry with one another. I am watching, and we are watching, families that would never have come in contact with one another actually talk about Jesus, and in the relationship has been focused on Jesus. And that is, we are not there to, as I always say, we're not there to rehabilitate the home. There is a great need for that too, but we are there to rehabilitate the heart. And that's been our focus. And we are seeing an impact, a direct impact, not only from four-year-olds at the pre-K school through the elementary school, fifth and sixth graders, to the high school, serving food to the basketball teams and the wrestling teams, and having one-on-one time with some of these young men. One of the neatest stories, there's a gentleman that I have come in contact with who I, years ago, actually had arrested numerous times for drug abuse. And he was addicted to crack cocaine, and it had him in a bad way. Hadn't seen him in years. And one day he walked in front of me, actually while I was working, in a suit. And I stopped and I said, "Daryl, what are you doing?" And he said, "Man, Officer Haley, how have you been?" I said, "Man, what's going on?" He said, "I'm clean." I said, "Well, how'd you do it?" And he goes, "By the grace of God." And so that has been impactful to me, but not only is that been impactful to me, Daryl is now reaching out to me on a regular basis, trying to get us, our church, New Albany Presbyterian Church, within this community to which now he lives, and he is trying to do outreach. So we are trying to partner with people that we know, and it's been a blessing, and it's, man, we are just at the beginning of it, and I can't wait to see what God's going to do with it.
Our mission statement at our church is to glorify God through lives changed by Jesus Christ. And for many years, I thought that was geared towards us, or me personally, of my life change, of glorifying God. And not that it isn't that, but it's not only that. It is glorifying God through lives that we can change through Jesus Christ, and lives that can be changed around us.
I'll be really bold and transparent and say that the Vitality Seminar initially was a task and a checkbox that the elders and leadership team looked at simply completing. The shock was a reawakening to what ministerial work from a service perspective meant. It challenged us to look and literally reconstruct how we are giving of our time and talent, and I would encourage every church to take on the challenge of bringing the Vitality Seminar in-house and changing the entire cultural perspective of how a church operates.